Have you ever done something you didn't want to do, but you were too afraid to look dumb or silly in front of your friends? Something like drinking alcohol or vaping? Welcome to GGTN Radio, a podcast where you will learn more about God, understand the Bible, and hear some great Christian music. We're your hosts, Esther and Steph. We want to see you flourish in your spiritual life every day. Hey girls, happy Friday. It's Steph here.
And it's me, Esther. We hope you're having a wonderful day and a great week.
Yeah. So girls, any plans this weekend? Esther, any plans?
Let me see. We are getting ready to go to a conference next weekend.
Already?
Yeah, next weekend.
Oh my goodness.
You're a little bit lost.
Just a tad.
So yes, we're getting ready for that. And also it's Easter Friday.
Oh my goodness. Gee, time's flown.
It's flown. So girls, happy Easter. Yes. There's a time when we remember our Lord, Jesus giving his life for us.
For us, yeah.
Yes, well, that's really special. All right, so.
Oh, yes, the question. So have you ever done something you didn't want to do, but you were too afraid to look dumb or silly in front of your friends? Something like drinking alcohol or vaping. I haven't done the alcohol or vaping or anything like that. But I think sometimes when you make stupid decisions, like, I don't know, like maybe attitude-wise or just ignoring someone sort of thing.
Yeah. I think I remember when I had a particular birthday and I remember one of my closest friends told me not to invite someone because he wasn't friends with her. And I didn't and I regretted that. I should have just invited the people I wanted there.
Yeah.
I remember that.
Wow.
That was silly.
Yeah.
You were younger.
Yeah, true.
So you probably were in a different world.
La la land.
Yeah, you were playing. But yeah, so I remember that. I think
alcohol and vaping and all the other silly stuff happening are pretty full on. But yeah, little decisions like that where someone controls your decision is also not good.
No, that happens at school as well when, you know, don't talk to her because I'm your friend. I don't like her. And so you end up taking on that same attitude.
You do.
And you're influenced. Because
you don't want to lose that friend and, you know, blah, blah. It's tricky, but sometimes you just have to say, you know what?
I'm going to do my own
thing. I have my own brain and decisions.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. So let's get into the story.
Peer pressure. Lillian laughed as her friend posed for another photo. Riley loved photos, selfies, and just being in the spotlight. Today more than ever, she was basking in the attention. The music in the background, the colored lights, and Riley's sparkling, glittering gold gown made it all so elaborate. Riley was an only child, and her parents had rented out a venue for her special day, her 18th birthday party. Lillian stuffed another spring roll in her mouth and watched Riley call over her boyfriend for another photo. Grinning, Lillian walked back to her table where Amanda and Julz were sitting. "Want a drink?" Amanda asked. "Sure, thanks," Lillian agreed, taking it. She needed to wash down the crunchy spring rolls. Taking the bottle, she quickly scanned it, like her dad and brother had warned her to. Oh, it had alcohol. She couldn't drink it. "Thanks, guys, but it's got alcohol," Lillian said, returning the bottle to her friends. "Well, it's an 18th, Lil, but we got it because it literally only says 1% alcohol," Julz stated, pointing to the line claiming the small percentage. Lillian knew you didn't need to be a math genius to know that 1% was really nothing. 1%, Lil, really? Amanda said, handing her back the bottle. Lillian read the ingredients and the percent of the alcohol. It really was only 1%. 1%, Julz, she heard her friends repeat. Lillian frowned, feeling a little angry at their insistence. Her friends knew that she didn't drink, and it had never been such a big deal before. But here, tonight, they looked at her as odd or over the top and ridiculous. She knew Julz drank now and then, and she was also a Christian. But she had been brought up differently. She knew alcohol was bad and God would never condone a food or substance that clouded the mind and reasoning. Suddenly, a verse popped into her head. Whoever is faithful in small matters will be faithful in large ones. Whoever is dishonest in small matters will be dishonest in large ones. Luke 16:10. I'm not drinking it, and you should respect that, Lillian said strongly. Her friend gaped at her, but nodded. Lillian felt happiness fill her as she stood up for her beliefs, but she also knew that she wouldn't have been put in that situation if she'd stayed home. Tonight made her realize that she didn't belong at these sort of parties. Next time, she'd give her friend the gift, but not attend. Taking out her phone, she texted her dad to pick her up.
Oh, I really...
I loved it.
I loved how she struggled, as in, you know, it kept going through her mind, but at the end she really stood up for what she believed. I really like that.
I liked it too.
Because it's not easy to do.
Oh, no, no, not at all.
At all.
I think also her friends... fortunately did stop there, even though they insisted. But I think there are other people that will mock you more, which makes it also harder.
Yes, I agree. I remember once when I was in my late teens and I was staying at my friend's house, and she was a Christian. Like, she was a Christian. And her family weren't really.
Yeah.
So they drank in that. And I remember that she got... They were having a party of some sort, somebody's birthday, an aunt or something. And then she bought alcohol from her. And we were legally, like, age. You know how people say, legally you can? Yeah. And so they served me a glass. And I could smell it. And I just saw it. And I brought it to my nose. And I smelled it. I'm like, this is disgusting. And I'm like, you know, no, thank you. I don't drink. They were great. I mean, they respected. Yeah. They were respectful people. But I could have.
You could have.
Just to see what it tasted like.
You had,
like,
I guess the adults you were staying with permission. You were overage.
Yes.
So there was really no...
I wasn't. And I could think about, you know, what would God do? Like, what would God think? He wouldn't do anything. Like, he's not going to strike us. He's not that type.
No, he won't.
But I'm like, how would I disappoint him? And then... you know, back at church the weekend, I would be doing praise and worship or doing... And I just felt hypocritical.
Yeah. So what do you actually think God feels when we do let ourselves get carried away with the peer pressure or bad influences?
Definitely sad. I mean, you know, a parent, when you make the wrong choice and something bad happens, they feel disappointed.
Yeah.
And I think God feels the same. He feels sad. And I was just going to say, it saddens him because that's why he came to die for us.
Yeah.
So that we could be saved from things like this.
Yeah, yeah.
And it saddens him that he gave his all and we are kind of just stepping all over it and saying, well, really, I don't care what he did.
Mm.
I'm just going to do my own thing anyways.
Yeah.
You know?
I think like reading what it says about, you know, bad influences, I think it makes him extra saddened because he tells you in the Bible, do not, you know, go with a bad crowd.
Mm.
You know, he tells you very clearly, avoid those crowds because you'll end up with them.
That's
right.
And
a bad company corrupts good morals.
Yes, I've got that verse later on.
Oh, do you?
Yes.
Oh, jumped to it. But, you know, it's clearly stated in the Bible. So God feels saddened because we put ourselves in that situation.
Mm. We also have to remember that he made us a unique version of ourselves with a brain to think for ourselves, and he wants us to use it. I remember last year we went to a conference, a women's conference, and we were in this lift and we were staying at we were staying at this place that was, you know, like really, really busy, really city, like kind of city, a lot of people, a lot of teens, a lot of young adults and that. And it's because it's a big hotel, a lot of people stay there. So we were coming down on the lift and there were, I think, about eight. They would have been, 19, 20, maybe from 19 to 22. And I remember that they were really loud and really, just really rude. And, you know, they were really just those kids. And I remember that one of them, I mean, I wasn't talking to them. We weren't talking to them at all or anything. We were just talking about our own thing. But I remember one of them said to me, he looked at me, he said, oh, he goes, so you're going out partying tonight and drinking? And it caught me off guard because I wasn't talking to them.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, what is this kid talking to me for? and then I turned around and I smiled and I just grinned. And I remember I said, oh, no, I said, I like to be in control of my emotions. Because when you drink, you're not in control. You lose it. And they were like, whoa, and they were saying all these things on the lift. And they looked at the girl that was with them, which she would have been maybe 21 the most.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, you should learn from her. because wow. you lose your emotions. Like, who knows what she did? But and then they walked out when the lifts open, and I'm thinking, I hope and God willing, she learned. Or they all learned something.
Yeah,
because I could have turned around and said, I don't drink, that's disgusting, you know, and be all righteous.
Yeah.
But instead I just said, no, I like to be in control of my emotions. And I think that was a God thing.
And obviously they knew that you do lose control.
Yes.
Wow.
But they do it a lot of time. There was eight of them and you could tell that they just were influenced with everybody, you know.
Yes.
Like they all influenced and you had to do what everybody else was doing. But I felt sorry for the girl because she was the only girl in the group and they were just, they looked down at her.
Wow.
So, yeah, oh my goodness, it's bad. Peer pressure.
That is true, actually. So, what can we actually do about it, girls? So, first, obviously, and always foremost, you ask God for help when you're tempted, you know, but you also stand up for your beliefs, even if no one else agrees. Just like our story. You know, it's not easy. There were her friends, they knew her, but they were pushing her. But she didn't let that, like, stop her from believing, like, standing up for what she believed. Being strong and faithful to God is really, really important.
It is. And reading his word daily, even though we say this all the time, it is so true. The more you read, the more you will grow spiritually. And then when your friends pressure you and or they tell you or demand from you to do something that, you know, you shouldn't, God is going to help you stand firm and give you that guts that you need.
And I also think, girls, deep, deep, deep down, you're going to be an example to your friends.
Mm.
You know, they're going to be like, oh, wow, she really does. They will admire it even if they don't tell you or even if they mock you.
And they'll respect. Deep down, they'll respect.
They do. And they will trust you more.
Mm-hmm.
They will see you have integrity and you're not going to be, you know, influenced around.
Yeah,
exactly. And that makes, that's a big, big thing.
So another thing you can do, which is so important, ask God to help you be an example to others or for others. That's really important.
And I think the other thing, which also makes it tricky, is if you're in a group of friends that supposedly have your same beliefs and they're the ones pressuring you, it makes it harder because they think you're a goody two-shoe and they mock you. And I've found, honestly, that sometimes people out of the church respect you more than the ones in the church because they're like, oh, you're a goody two-shoe. I'm like, we believe the same thing. Like, what? What's – yeah. And I've found that. And sometimes it's quite annoying and intimidating. And sometimes that just also means you need to find new friends, new Christian friends, because the ones you have, unfortunately, are not the right ones. So you need to move on.
Yeah. And, you know, your friends or people in general need to see Christ reflected in you. And you need to be like a testimony for those around you.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, choose good friends like Steph was saying.
Yeah, you don't need to be like righteous, but you do need to stand up for what you believe.
Mm.
You know, they know what they're doing, if it's right or wrong.
Okay, so the verses I was telling you about.
Oh, yes.
It's found in 1 Corinthians 15:33, and I've got three different versions because they all say different things, but they're really nice.
Yeah, yeah.
So, like, I've got the NIV, I've got the ERV, and I've got the Message.
Okay, cool. Let's start. Let's start.
So the NIV says, "Do not be misled. Bad company corrupts good character." Then the ERV says, "Don't be fooled. Bad friends will ruin good habits." And then the Message says, "But don't fool yourself. Don't let yourself be poisoned by this anti-resurrection's loose talk. Bad company ruins good manners."
That is amazing. And I go back to just the old saying where it says, a rotten apple ruins a lot.
Mm.
If you have right now in your fridge a rotten apple, are you going to leave it in the middle of the good ones?
Or eat it?
You're going to chuck it out straight away. You don't want to spoil the rest of them. It's the same with your character, your soul, girls, your mind.
Yeah. So like Steph was saying that if people you're hanging around don't respect your faith, it's time to move on. They're really not your friends, the friends that God is going to bless. So you need to move away and get involved in your youth groups at church.
And if it's your youth group that's being a little dodgy, find a new youth group because like I'm really fortunate. I've got really great Christian friends that we believe the same things. But there are others that I'd had to move away from because their beliefs were completely different, but they were professing to be the same as ours. So you need to make those tough choices.
Yeah, and there are. So don't stay home wishing that you have good friends, but you don't participate in anything or in any activities. You keep yourself hidden at home. You need to push through.
Yeah, pray for God's courage.
Yeah, and ask God. I believe this 100%, and I do this for my nieces. I pray for them to have good friends. And you know what? God has brought some amazing friends for them. They do travel a little bit, like an hour and a half from where we are to these new groups, to different churches they visit down there, like south. But they are amazing and they're loving it.
They are loving it.
And so they're loving church more because they've got friends. And so
friends
that
believe the same thing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Spiritual friends that actually help them lift up instead of bringing them down.
Yeah.
And I think that's important. So you do, girls, need to make an effort.
So girls, above everything, and we've said it again, we're like a broken record, but pray to God for strength and for the wisdom in your choices. Actually, that reminds me. Okay, so this morning I was reading a devotional and I actually wanted to send it to my nieces because I loved what it said. So I'm going to read directly from it. It's a little, I'll get bits and pieces from it. It's from the Bible app. And this morning's was just beautiful and I loved it. So it says, every decision we make matters, but the most important decision we will ever make is whether we choose to follow Jesus Christ.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And it says, choosing to believe and follow Jesus changes everything. We are not only saved for eternity, but we also get to have a relationship with God today. And I just loved it because it is a choice, girls. We choose. I mean, it actually originally starts with this sentence. It says the average person makes over 35,000 decisions a day. Mm-hmm. I actually stopped there and thought, wait, what am I deciding? How many things? But it's true. What am I going to eat? What am I going to wear? What am I going to, you know, choose? Am I stopping my timer at this time? Like everything is a decision. And making sure that God is our first priority is just amazing. So girls, make the right choice because it actually is going to shape the course of the whole day and then the rest of your life.
That's true. Amen. I love that. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for another Friday. Thank you that we've seen another week through. And thank you that your love is all over us. Lord, today I ask that you give the girls who are listening as well as us the strength to stand up for what we believe so that we can be faithful to you and that others can come to know you because we are reflecting your love. Lord, thank you for dying for us on the cross as we remember this beautiful Easter weekend. May we feel your presence, your love surrounding us each time. In your name I ask, amen.
You're listening to Mariah Peters. I choose Jesus.
I have searched to find the meaning of this life, something that would fill my empty soul. Some believe a lie, choose darkness over light, but I will stand and let the whole world know. Trusting in one name, 'cause
don't forget that you are Gigi, gorgeous in God's image, dearly loved by God.